When it comes to fervent discussions among the theme park fandom, none cause more outrage than the introduction of IPs, or intellectual properties. From a tower of terror or 45-minute trudge through a showcase of energy sources becoming the headquarters for mixtape-loving Galaxy Guardians, to entire lands being transformed into shrines to a singular movie, studio, or franchise, according to some fans, if it's not an original idea, it's not worth pursuing. And because someone's gotta be to blame for it, fingers usually point in the direction of current CEO of the Walt Disney Company, Bob Chapek, for the seemingly sudden shift. Because it couldn't be remakes, Marvel, or Star Wars movies dominating the box office or guest satisfaction metrics that might have anything to do with it. The new Mickey Mouse shorts were just that good, so that's why your precious great movie ride had to die. And yet, there are still a handful of attractions at the parks that haven't fallen into the clutches of this synergistic practice. Which got me thinking, which of these attractions need IPs? And yes, I'm 100% serious about this. Ignore the release date, it's irrelevant. Let's start in DCA, and since the expansion of Pixar Pier is inevitable, the Golden Zephyr is kind of the last ride standing that's avoided any major alteration. So if it's going to have a Pixar reskin, the obvious choice is to turn it into Charles Muntz's blimp, the Spirit of Adventure, from Up. Not much would have to be changed either. Just have Doug do the safety spiels, in English and Spanish, and maybe slap some decals of the other dogs on the side of the ride vehicles, but that's it. The other ride in that area untouched since opening is Jumpin' Jellyfish, but you can easily make that Nemo related by painting the ride vehicles pink and calling it Jumpin' Jellies. Literally. But now let's move on to Adventureland, and no, I'm not going to suggest the Jungle Cruise be remade with movie elements, whenever that comes out, or even revive Tiki Room under new management. Because in my opinion, the latter didn't go far enough. Yeah, it had Iago from Aladdin and Zazu from The Lion King as the new hosts, and Iago was complaining the whole time about how the original version was old and stupid. But have y'all ever seen Tokyo's version? The Enchanted Tiki Room, Aloha e Komo Mai, featuring Stitch, is arguably the correct way to implement an IP into this attraction. But I'm talking a full-blown IP takeover here. Replace all the parrots with Iago, Zazu, Heihei from Moana, and, sure, the Otacuan. Then throw in Stitch and, while they're at it, Maui. It'll be a big old cavalcade of modern Disney songs to get everyone in the audience singing.
Rockin' Stutz all but halls are welcome.
But then there's the Jungle Cruise, which is getting an update later to focus less on racism and more on the skippers. I legitimately cannot wait. But since my family has this weird habit of mistakenly calling the Jungle Cruise the Jungle Book ride, I mean, honestly, how bad can that be? You already have the elephants and a tiger that very well could be Shere Khan, so why not replace the gorillas trashing the camp with King Louie? Even though there's already a Disney movie where gorillas are trashing a camp. Actually, no, yeah, go with that one. And I guess the African Veldt scene could easily be remade into Pride Rock. And they'd have to license Skipper Dan to play in a loop in the queue. It's the Skipper's favorite song.
Don't ever say Skipper Dan.
You know, the more I think about this, the more I legitimately want it to happen. So let's just dial it back, calm ourselves down, just think about another Disney attraction that desperately needs an upgrade. So, Small World. Now, Disney stirred up a lot of controversy a few years ago when they actually decided to put Disney characters in the attraction, granted in that classic Mary Blair style, and placing them in the respective countries, which I'm pretty sure Donald Duck isn't Latin American, but okay. But wasn't there a Small World animated series a while back? That looked cute and would have been a perfect fit for Disney Junior.
It's a small Disney Junior world.
All those dolls, get rid of them. Replace them with figures of Doc McStuff and Sophia the First and Vampirina. And older ones like Handy Manny, Roly Poly Oly, JoJo's Circus, Bear in the Big Blue House. Not Little Einsteins. However, I will accept the Lion Guard and the Rocketeer because they are adorable. And of course they would sing the song, why wouldn't they? It's a world of laughter, a world of tears, it's a world of hope and a world of fear. Okay, I'm going a little off the deep end here because at this point I can look at any Disney attraction and shoehorn a property in that has no business being part of its legacy. Big Thunder Bounden Railroad!
Okay, hear me out.
Okay, Bounden is a pretty obscure Pixar short when you think about it, but it has a lot of critters in there that are very similar to the ones found on Big Thunder Mountain, so just update the designs and put the jackalope where the goat is, and there you have it! Okay, what else? Great moments with Mr. Lincoln? Why not great moments with Mr. Ellis? Eh? Eh? More Marvel in the parks? Eh? And you know, forget about those dumb Grand Canyon and Primeval World dioramas on the train. Homeward Bound and Dinosaur Baby! Soren will take you through scenes of Peter Pan, Dumbo, Rescuers Down Under, and Planes Now! Disney will have to buy the rights, but Living with the Land could be VeggieTales the Ride! Fern Gully River Rapids and Animal Kingdom! Doctor Strange's Everest Expedition! The Cat from Outer Space Mountain! Thank you all so much for watching, and once again, happy April Fool's Day. This is clearly a topic that I have been wanting to talk about for a little bit, or just be a little bit snarky about, and I mean, after all, theme Snark, it's the name of the channel. Maybe one day I'll go a little bit further into my thoughts about this topic, or Haley might even want to do that someday. Who knows? But if you want me to go ahead and do that at some point, leave a comment down below and persuade me. I've been wanting to broadcast my goals for the channel going forward, kind of like how Quentin Reviews does, in order to kind of persuade people into wanting to subscribe and seeing me talk about these things. So let's just say I'll do that IP video around 3,500. Well, that's not too far off now. However, liking, commenting, and subscribing is but one form of support you can do for this channel. If you would like to do so monetarily, you may do so like these folks whose names you are seeing scroll by on screen over on Patreon. For as little as a dollar a month, you too can get sneak peeks at future projects that I am working on in the form of clips or even full episodes if I get them out on time. I'm probably going to push myself to finish this one so Patreon can see it before it goes live on the 1st for today, as well as seeing your name scroll by on screen and said aloud by me if you are a newcomer such as Tyler Campbell and Caesar Journey Vlog. However, if you are willing to dig a little deeper into your pockets to support little old me with, say, $10 or more a month, you are inducted into the Cool Cats Club and join the ranks of Chad Blankenship, Cyborg for Life, Gabby Tyrell, Jerry Callahan, newcomer Catherine Esperanza, Mark Aquino, Pander Plays, Tony Goldmark, and Wesley Fox. Any amount will do. You can cancel any time, and during these interesting times, I'm not going to hold a grudge against you if you choose not to give me money. Once again, if we hit 3,500 subscribers on this channel, I'll go ahead and make my video about the intellectual properties used in the parks, as well as also working on the Wizarding World video for the Universal retrospective. And it's a safe bet that it's probably not going to be coming out in the next few days because I'm still writing it. And yeah, I'm also going back to work too, so complications on top of complications. But again, thank you so much for watching. A lot more stuff coming. And as always, stay safe, stay healthy. Black Lives Matter, trans rights are human rights. Stop Asian hate. Like, share, subscribe, all that good stuff. And bonus nachos, kids. Ugh. Oh, look, buttons. Click them.
Click them. Click the buttons. There's a button. There's a button. There's another button. There's some buttons.